Hej alle sammen. Hello my subs. Nu er det nået til den næste visning af en diffusionspumpe. En speciel en, hvor vi laver en dykpumpe om til en diffusionspumpe. Det er et lille hack, jeg kan. Hello my friends. Now I'm ready to do some little hack on a water pump. Old submersible water pump, so that doesn't change, but we want to make a powerful Venturi water pump. A diffusion pump here is not ready to be made now, because we need to do some pottery on the fireplace by making a disc for this one here. This is not now. We take some hoses. We have an old pump, the motor and the impeller is gone, because that does not work. That took the RCD, it failed. Trevor here, so that is not good. So, how to do it? You just simply take some hoses. This hose here must be fine for now. And put it there. See. Yes, it's very good. So we want to stick it up into the piping. Good. And to stick it up, wants to bend it. And yes. Her kan I se, hvordan man laver sådan en slangebøjning her. Now we get some little trouble, because we have mounted the piping. The piping should be mounted because it's a sewage grinder pump, actually. Almost. The chopper blades lay, and last year I cut myself because I does not. I took the impeller with the hands and I sliced my, so that's not good. Now you can see. Now we want to guide the hoses up. Not totally up, but some up into the pipe. And so we want to put down it. It must be unacceptable, but we can measure it. We need to adjust the hose like that. So it actually has to turn it until we can. Before we can connect it again, we need to connect the piping, and the packing tape needs to be replaced every time you use it. So this type of pump here I am creating can be very, very, very powerful when you have a lot of slurries and sewage, raw sewage that needs to be pumped, and you don't want a grinder pump and you don't want to maintenance. Yes, now it's ready. Somehow. Now we need to mount the top cover. The actual final top cover is not ready to be mounted because I need to drill some bigger holes to the hoses. And my Christmas tree drill is not big enough for that. So we want to get the screws. Yes, and always keep in mind how simple you can do it. The electricity is not necessary here because that one will feed the air hose system and become a yes, it will become a very powerful pump because I will I have a small furnace somewhere can mount underneath this made a powerful diffusion pump. And because I am does not need them does not need the clean air, I can actually use some of the hot gases from the steam to the soul air to burst the air down. That will make a powerful pump. A very powerful pump. This will be done very soon. And it will require some clay pottery to make that. Assembling this pump here is a bit complicated because the screws is very tight and very strong. So we need to tighten. Only hand tight when you assemble the pump, but when you have hand tied it, you can mount it. Directly, you can begin to tighten the wheel. Yes, it's not the cleanest one. It has some patina or what you just call it. Not want to use because the pumps could handle bigger solids and the water amount that can get through this is not big enough, so we need to do it in other places. To drill some small hole here to get a hose onto it. So when you use this pump, you can pump water back to that installation and it will work better. Dealing with the sewage water, I hope that I don't human sewage, but only sediment in the local lake I want to dry out for mud and other things that does not want to be in the lake. It will be fun. The diffusion pump will run on water. No oil, because we don't want oil explosion when we punch air through this hose here. The hose will be mounted here onto that one, but it will not get put out fully here, because I will mount some flexible air hoses, hydraulic hoses. I'm using some piping onto them, because we don't want to terminate hoses directly to this pump, so I want to terminate it. So you can use this pump like my other project. You can carry around to show people how fine and well made your technology is. This is a very, very low tech, very, very simple pump. But I will tell you, that one here will work fine, very fine. It just looked too simple to push the hose up until the delivering pipe, but when you get a diffusion pump with this power amount, I will fire it with wood and small pieces of sticks and other. It will actually produce so much heat, the pump here will run very, very, very powerful. This, I don't want to drill, but there can be needed to drill the hole. Let's see how bad condition this hole is in. Some piping that can go through, but yes, always tighten the round movement. So you see that. Now then, continue the rounding until you tighten all the screws. Because when you tighten one screw, you can set the other screws. And you need to continue that until it passes good. The legs for this pump need to be like a standard sewage grinder pump or sewage lifting pump of Bonfoss. So the legs will be cut, and I don't know how to cut the legs out now, but I'm thinking I use some piece of wood to cut it. That's fine. Let's see how we can get a half inch pipe through that. Let's see. Expand the hole, even if the drill is not big enough, because aluminium, you can always use a big scissors to embarrass the hole and consolidate. that awesome feature in aluminium. But the problems with the aluminium is the it is not a durable piece of metal, this one here. Guess it works. Let's see about the pipe can go through now. Still cannot. But don't lose my mind about that. We have a burner, but this is the last solution to burn the aluminium. This is the last solution. So we want to bend the steel wire and do it again. This is hard for your hands to use both hands to this type of operation here. Because this is a strange way to cut aluminium, but it actually works very, very well. Wow, the pipe is actually fun to use. Yes. Now you need to adjust the piping so you can mount that. Well, then it needs to be fully thread up. Sharp edges on the aluminium. Now we can get a hydraulic hoses onto that. But somehow I need to mount the inner hoses onto that. First we want to measure it. Yeah. So you need to cut it. And for the cutting, you want to use that. Yes, yes, it has to be done. First I want to remove excess hoses. I try to avoid cutting the hoses extra, but sometimes
Yes, John Deere.
It's very, very cool here. So I need to use a leather hose. I understand why this is a very, very dangerous tool. Now, let's see, it looks good here. Yes. And so it must look good here. Yes. Yes, but the piping, this is the critical part. We need to clean the hoses, and maybe I need to put in another video because now I have 6 minutes. It's still filming. I always avoid glue in my videos because glue takes too long. The tape here can be used in the hoses. But the hose need to be cleaned and always use tape in my videos, but if I don't film, I always use glue. Maybe this one also needs to be glued because of the high pressure. Sometimes I use a piece of heat shrink to make the joint stronger. Maybe I need to do it here, maybe I does not need to do it here. But the connecting of the pump will be in a separate video because if I need shrinking, because I think it's not time now. Yeah. Oh, the holes. Maybe too good. Let's see how much time we have back. 4 minutes. Yes, it must convert done. All we want is to just simply push everything in, and yes, screw it into place. This is a very, very difficult task. Yes, and so we want to wait time. Housing. Yes, and of course we need to
Ich bin nicht gut.